Okay, so I'm still here, guys, still casting. Now I have Wacky Chinese out of Zalay. We're going to bring you the first game out of Group H, it was. We have Purple versus Aki Wonder. So they are on their first life. Like, even if they lose, they still have one more chance. And if they win, they have to take one out of the next two afterwards. So they're in a really good spot.
Yeah, Aki Wonder has Druid, Mage, and Warlock.
And Purple has Druid, Shaman, Warrior.
We have no idea what the archetypes are yet, although Radu seems to think he knows them all.
Yeah, before the series, I was making a bet with Jackie. I was telling him that I think Aki Wonder brings Khitun Druid, Tempo Mage, with one Flamestrike, and Zoo. Purple will bring York Druid, Aggro Shaman, Dragon Warrior. That's my bet. Shall we do a wager?
Let's find out. Nah, can't afford that.
You believe me, okay. Yeah, the players, I think they're ready. They're deciding their starting deck. It's very important in last hero standing to start with the optimal deck, because if you get the 1-0, you can like push it.
Counter your opponent.
Yeah. I mean, it depends. If your decks are built that way, you can have like a weird strategy where like every deck of yours, you don't know what you do against your opponent. Maybe you can tell us more about that. You just like play free heavy control decks with like Nzoff. You're like, yeah, I will start the lead deck.
Yeah. Ah, it's working so far.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're still thinking.
Yeah.
They're both like top tier players, and their group is super hard. It's probably the hardest.
Who are the other two in the group?
I think it was. I don't know who it was, but I remember it was the hardest group. I just knew like it was the hardest group. Yeah. I don't want to like confuse it. So let's just go into the game and like talk about Hearthstone.
So we have Tempo Mage, which I'm happy to see. Love a bit of Tempo Mage.
Purple is like already smiling. He's like, yes. This is like insane hand.
Yeah.
You could even keep the Doomhammer with this hand, to be honest.
I'm not going to disagree. Yeah, drops the Doomhammer. Okay. Oh, wow. Okay.
Ooh, juicy.
Yeah, AK's Hundred Wonders hand not looking quite so great.
Yeah, Aki Wonder has Flame Waker, Faceless Summoner, and Arcane Blast. There's options in his mulligan, and he's still deciding. I think the optimal way is to just keep Arcane Blast, which he does.
Yeah, old Cult Sorcerer is nice to have.
Yeah. They combine really well into killing the...
Yeah, but Purple's hand is pretty ridiculous right now. I mean, if you could ask for a starting hand, other than Tome Golem, like...
Purple is playing very fast. I think you just pass here. No need to like invest more resources.
Yeah, I mean, it opens up the option, so he has the option of Feral Spirit next turn if he wants to.
The question is, will Aki Wonder play the Cold Sorcerer or wait for the Totem Golem?
I mean, if you didn't have the Arcane Blast in hand, you'd go for the Cold Sorcerer for sure, right? But with the Arcane Blast, you kind of want to hold back. He does that.
Yeah, and there's extra incentive to wait. But now, Purple has the options. I think a Trog, all or nothing.
Trog and abusive? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, seems good.
Just go in.
All out.
All out.
Faces the place.
Yep. Okay. Purple is really known in the scene for like almost always optimally choosing to go face when it's needed. Yeah. Like a lot of players just overtrade. Purple will never overtrade.
Yeah.
Purple just like lets his opponent trade for him.
Yeah, seems good. Whoa, when you're playing a super aggressive deck. I mean, he has the Feral Spirit follow-up as well. This Feral Spirit is going to be so insane with the two Trogs on board.
Yeah, Aki Wonder just has like a pretty easy turn. Arcane Blast Ping is pretty efficient at dealing with the board.
Yeah.
And that's how he set it up for the current play with the ping that he had last turn, right?
Yeah, I mean, he's got a pretty reactive hand. He has the War Rally for next turn.
Water Rally is like... pretty good if your opponent cannot kill it, because then you'll like guaranteed block his Doomhammer.
Yeah.
Purple is singing. Maybe we can get like some
Radio Purple.
Yeah. He's really enjoying that music, blasting in his headset.
So will he go with the Arcane Blast Ping? Yeah, looks like he's going
to. Yeah. There's no other option. He's probably like taking some of the time to like think of the future turns. Again, really well set up by Aki Wonder.
Oh wow! Okay.
You might just coin it out, yeah. Purple
no,
does it.
No hesitation. Just
no hesitation. Yeah. purpose. No, I'll take that.
Yeah, I mean, what?
I'll take that too.
Yeah, I mean, Tempo Mage has no way of dealing with this. Like, Fireball isn't enough.
Yeah.
And the War Elemental suddenly looks nowhere near as good as it did a minute ago.
Yeah, you know what's better than 4 mana 7-7? 3 mana 7-7. Purple is very happy. Also, like, the 7-7 also gives 2 charge damage. 2 damage instantly on the Trog.
Yeah, yeah.
It's permanent charge damage. It's insane. It's like a Blue-Gilled Warrior added to the Trog.
Blue-Gilled Warrior. Goes for the Frostbolt into...
Images.
Okay, so
that's interesting.
Saving his face here.
Yeah. Purple will just hero power here. No need to, like, put the Rockbiter just yet. Also, like, helps in cost reducing the thing from below.
Yeah, you have, like, a nice Feral Spirit hero power turn, potentially.
If he wants to Rockbiter, he can do it next turn, too. It's not, like, a rush.
Yeah. Wonder draws the Azure Drake. The Fireball still isn't... I mean, you want to play the Fireball with the cool Sorcerer, right? To kill the 7-7, so... Azure Drake's a pretty decent draw.
Azure Drake is decent if he survives. Like, now purple... Oh, that's interesting. Multiple lines of play rise for purple.
Yeah.
So you can go Lava Burst on the Drake and then miss a lot of damage but clear the board, put your opponent in a pretty bad shape, but I don't like that. Purple will never do that play. The play that I see purple doing is like...
Oh, he doesn't? Okay.
Argent Horizard or Biter into the Drake, maybe.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's a pretty tough turn. Like, Feral Spirits never play. Thing from Below never a play. Lava Burst is an option, but you miss a lot of damage. I don't like it.
Yeah.
And the other option is just going Horse Rider into the 0-2 and then pushing 7 to the face. That's something I would see purple doing. Very aggressive player again.
Yeah, it's aggressive. But at the same time, AK Wonder would probably be...
Wait, what about this? What if you trade the Horse Rider into the 0-2 and you put the 7-7 into the 4-4 because you know that he used Frostbolt already?
Yeah. Yeah, I like... I mean, that's... He goes with the 7-7 into the Torn, which is interesting.
Still plays for the board, more efficient than if he would have done it with Lava Burst. I don't mind it, I think it's fine.
Yeah, it's okay.
So now the sources that you said...
Yeah, he could go with the... But maybe he'd rather just ping, because the Cold Sorcerer would just die to the Horse Rider.
Yeah, I don't mind the ping.
Interesting.
What?
Interesting. Yeah. Medivh being on point again. What about playing Surge Apprentice, Water Elemental, Mirror Images, and then like next time you have like an explosive turn?
Potentially, but
it's like
you really want to leave the 7-7 on board and risk? Like he could trade
risk what?
Risk like, the 7-7 trading into the Water Lily. Are you not bothered about that? Are you just like 7-7 into Water Lily? It's gonna be frozen next turn.
He didn't have anything last turn. Like, why would he have something now?
Yeah. So he does go with the Cool Sorcerer.
Ooh.
Tusker. Wow, okay. That fills out his curve nicely.
You can go Tusker Ferals, and then that overloads you.
Okay. Oh, okay. He goes for the thing from below. Interesting.
Maybe he still plays Tusker, and he goes for like Ferals thing next turn.
I guess maybe he's thinking about Flamestrike. Maybe potentially it's coming up to
okay.
the Mage's turn 7. Doesn't want to play too hard in Flamestrike.
But... You want to somehow bait the Flamestrike and then like just expand afterwards?
Yeah, but this
I'm not sure this is
good
enough.
Yeah, it doesn't really.
I mean, you'd Flamestrike if you had like 2 Flamestrikes in your hand and nothing else, but other than that, I don't think you'd do it.
Yeah. It's a nice turn from AK Wonder getting back on the board.
Yeah, AK Wonder just goes ham.
I would love to see that Yogg be played this game.
Yeah, you're like one of the players that pushed Yogg's around. Thank you very much, Jackie.
No problem, man.
I mean, I cannot complain. I want to major with Yogg-Saron.
Yeah.
Praise Yogg is like the optimal line of playing competitive Hearthstone.
Lava Burst in the War, really.
I'm not sure if I like this.
Really?
Flame Tongue would have been pretty cool instead of like hero powering. Purple really likes to like greed out the hero power, maybe too much.
Yeah. I mean, are you really bothered about the 2 taunts? Like, you can kill them next turn anyway. That more War Elemental might have... Oh, he finds another War Elemental.
Yeah, now you can trade the 5-5. And afterwards, like, be able to trade one of the 0-2 totems into the 3-2 sorcerers.
Yeah, goes for the ping on the 5-5.
That's not really the most efficient way, because you have he has a healing totem.
Yeah.
I think Akawanda's game plan at this point is like Yogg-Saron.
Yeah, praise Yogg.
Pretty set on Yogg-Saron.
Doomhammer, okay. Opens up another option, but I think the Flame Tongue seems pretty solid here.
So you trade with the 5-4, play the Flame Tongue, trade one.
Oh, I guess with the Doomhammer, okay.
Okay, okay, okay. I can dig that.
Takes the damage to face. He's still on full health, so he's not bothered about taking it.
Yeah,
damage.
Yeah. I can dig this. It's fine. It's only bad if the Tempo Mage just, like, jams Harrison on your face right now.
Yeah, yeah. Fireball. Well, that's a way of dealing with a 5-5.
Pretty good way, yeah.
And the Water Lily gets the face.
Yeah.
This is closer, actually. It looks, at first, it seemed like Purple was getting ahead, but...
I mean, he's gonna come to Yo GG Saron.
Another Tusker.
Yeah, Tusker feeds really well here. You Tusker first, and then you see what you get.
Yellow Totem Golem. I mean, he could just trade all the totems into the Water Elemental.
Yeah, that's what he's gonna do, I think. Got to trade them all.
How many spells AK Wonder used so far? It's Yogg's. I'm gonna do that much.
He is pretty big, but I don't think he's insane. I think he still played.
Yeah, I think he played.
You believe in the Yogg. Okay, let's see.
Praise Yogg!
Praise Yogg!
Cleave, not bad.
Purple is not really enjoying himself right now. He's not even watching.
Infest. Oh, wow.
Ooh!
Clears a lot of the board. Sense Demons. I swear every time you play Yogg, he always plays Sense Demons. Yeah, on the Hunter's own face.
Unfortunately, Sense Demons is like super bad. You get two worthless teams. Like,
would you have considered holding on to the excess mana there in case you draw like a Flame Waker or something like that next turn?
It would be a consideration.
Like, what are you using? There's nothing you can find to play.
Yeah,
this
yeah.
Turn.
I think it was a small misstep. I remember doing it myself at DreamHack.
Yeah.
And I realized, these kind of mistakes are like mostly relevant, but they can be relevant in like the 1% where he just like misses some damage because of it. I don't know, like, this game is very interesting. Like, Purple would just, like, SM work this.
Yeah. And that Yogg's managed to fill AK Wonder's hand back up a bit.
I mean, he has worthless teams, which are jack shit.
Yeah.
He cannot do anything with them. AK Wonder needs Flame Strike.
Do we know if he plays one or two or none?
One.
One, okay.
I know he plays one because he played two. He played my list at Valencia and then he told on stream that he doesn't like two and he will not play two again.
Ah, okay, fair enough.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm playing two.
People don't hashtag believe enough. Yeah, good. You're doing it right. I didn't bring Tempo Mage. Ooh! Wow. What the fuck?
Okay. So he didn't really want to take any more damage there.
Did you see what he got? King Crush.
That's what I say. That's crazy. Yeah, I didn't even. You were going whoa, and I was like, what's he whoa-ing at?
Look at Purple's face. Purple is like, yeah.
That's
he has
8
it.
Damage to the face.
Yeah.
Oh, and now a fireball would be lethal.
He has it. He needs exactly Town Totem. And even that is probably not going to be enough.
Oh, the King Crush.
Yeah, Purple knows he
from
said.
From the Infest.
He looks at the casters. He's like, what the fuck
what
is this?
What just happened? Wow, Yogg into
Purple
Infest
is in agony.
Into King Crush.
Purple is suffering on live television right now.
Not
he's
a lot you can do about that.
Yeah, Infest from Yogg-Saron into King Crush, because why not?
Yeah.
Just dome him.
Yeah. Of
16
all,
damage.
Of all the beasts you can get, probably the one you'd ask for.
Yeah, pretty good beast.
Okay, so Purple keeps up with his warrior. We can see already it's C'Thun warrior.
Yeah. As Akawanda, I think he just like... Akawanda has the options of keeping Flame Waker, Mana Worm, Frostbolt. What do you think of Mana Worm, Frostbolt keep into just Mana Worm, Frostbolt face?
Well, it depends what kind of warrior they are. Like, if they're an aggressive, say, Dragon Warrior, obviously the Frostbolt's great for Alexstrasza champion, stuff like that.
Okay.
But I really love the Mana Worm into Frostbolt face.
I would keep Frostbolt, but I wouldn't use it on face. Like, you want to go... Now, usually you'd just pass turn one and hope you draw images and go like Mana Worm images.
Yeah.
Oh, he keeps even the Flame Waker. Akawanda is going deep in this game. Oh, Water Elemental. That's a curve. Arcanine kept his whole hand and he wants to go deep.
Yeah, it's fair enough. I mean, there's no Winx.
One thing is that you can play very, very aggressive once you, like, stole a game. Like, you won a game that you're not supposed to win, so you can afford to, like, risk more in the next games.
Yeah. Fair enough. Makes sense. Karma.
I mean...
Okay. So, I mean...
No, you don't frostbolt face. Or do you? No, you don't.
Of course you frostbolt face.
No. Yeah, just testing you.
Yeah, you just removed it.
Yeah.
The minion.
Until now, both players played really, really well. Maximizing the efficiency of their decks.
Yeah. AK1 is going to have to be really aggressive, though. It's kind of against Tempo Mage against C'Thun War. It's kind of a race against time, killing them before they get their plus 10 armor and etc.
The only thing I didn't like from Aqua Wonder is that he kept Flame Waker in his starting hand. I don't think there's like a card that you'd keep against Warrior, especially off coin.
I guess because you already have the turn 1, turn 2, it's kind of guaranteeing you've got turn 3 play. But.
Yeah, but unless you plan on frostbolting the face, and then like even if you frostbolt face, you follow up with Flame Waker, like.
Yeah.
I don't know. By the way, I lost the prediction because Purple is playing C'Thun Warrior, not Dragon Warrior. Feels bad, man.
Does indeed.
C'Thun Warrior is interesting. But, I don't know. I'd rather have Dragon Warrior. Dragon Warrior is pretty good. Brawl?
There's the War Rex. Three turns Sylvanas. Too late.
Yeah Sylvanas into Brawl is safer.
Yeah.
It takes some more damage, but it's safer.
Yeah.
Now, AK1 I think just draws, maybe images. Do you even want an image here? Like, you know your opponent's gonna brawl. You could just, like, double trade. You could just trade the 3-5 or the 4-4 into the 3-3, and then go with the other one to the face. Just Drake into the ghoul. Water ready face. Pass. What can purple do? I mean, pass after you draw with the intellect, obviously. I don't want to just, like, pass here.
Just to pass.
I don't think he's that far ahead that he can, like, give his opponent an advantage like that. Yeah.
Okay. I mean, it's kind of... Sylvanas is always annoying to deal with in Tempo Mage. I mean, wow, he goes full face, mirror image. I like it.
SM Mort, man.
He is... I mean, it kind of almost... I was going to say it plays around Brawl because it gives them your chance of a 0-2 taunt winning the Brawl, but I guess he's going to trade off first.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't even... Yeah, it goes with the Brawl.
Trades first, so I guarantee a good steal. Or a good survival. Ting-ting. Steals does with Drake.
Yeah.
How big is the C'Thun? Can we check? Yeah, we can check, right? We can check on your thing. 8-8.
It is an 8-8.
Not so good enough to get the... value from the 7 drops, unfortunately.
Which is really annoying. And he decided not to keep in it opening hand. He had 2 C'Thun's Chosen, the 4 mana Divine Shield, which he could have kept. But
it's not the best card against Tempo Mage, to be honest.
That's true. I mean, it's more of an anti-control.
Yeah, but the 7 drops are the best cards against Tempo Mage, so...
Yeah, it's kind of... You kind of need... Like, these 7 drops, you really want to play them, but you just can't. Like, I mean, would you...
Purple seems sad.
It does indeed.
Now he has like the face of like, why do I play this deck?
Like, why would you even? I was gonna say, would you consider playing the just 1/4/6 taunt? But I guess you need to kill the Flame Waker.
Yeah, you need to like not take damage or extra damage in this case. Yep, purple is pretty sad.
Ooh, so we have the Cult Sorcerer or Rag. I mean, I guess you just drop Rag, right? 8 to the face. And then you have the fireball follow-up for the turn after.
Yeah, this is probably game over for Aqua Wonder. Also known as Wonder, taking this game. 2-0 for also known as Wonder.
Tempo Mage taking 2 wins. Tempo Mage coming through strong. I'm happy. I really like Tempo Mage.
Yeah, I really like Tempo Mage too, but I don't think it was like the best pick for this tournament.
No.
Maybe I'm wrong. Yeah, it's okay.
I mean, usually it struggles against C'Thun Warrior as well, so that was a big win for
Yeah.
Okay, I wonder.
Also, it should struggle against Druid, which Purple still has. Purple has Druid against Taka Wonders, Temple Mage, Druid, Zoo.
Yeah.
That's Mission Impossible. But instead of Tom Cruise, we have Purple. A young gentleman from Canada. Is he going to be able to Tom Cruise it?
I mean, that's the kind of Druid hand you want to see, right?
Yeah. Purple knows what's up. He knows how to Druid. Yeah. Druid 101.
Yeah.
Actually, it's Druid 1-4. That's like the the Druid hand.
I got 3-0'd by Life Coach's Druid earlier. So I'm just feeling bad.
The Life Coach is also like really good with Druid. He likes to like maximize the percentages.
Yeah. Yeah, so he also has the Wrath, removes some early threats.
Yeah. You also have Roots for the early threats. Oh, Roots into part of the wild. Already we have options.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. Purple should feel happier. He's not happy because he knows Taka Wonder has his own Druid, which is like a mirror match, 50-50.
Yeah.
And the Zoo, which is like unfavored. So he has like a slightly favored, a slightly unfavored in the mirror match. That's very bad percentages of winning the series, but Purple is a top tier player which can do it.
Do magic things.
Yeah. Just double innervate every game.
Just wild skill.
Wild skill. He's playing a good druid, at least. He's not playing like the Gara druid. With like death rattles and stuff. That was wacky. That was some deck that I would expect from you, but you played a good druid deck, or a decent one at least.
Yeah, I like my druid. Okay, so Onyxia. I'd like to see Onyxia. Ooh, the arcane missiles draw. So he could go for just the apprentice into the missiles here.
Yeah, he's pretty powerful,
hope,
I would say.
Hope to clear up the living roots.
What if they all go face? Just free to the face.
Then you would feel very bad. But he gets the result he was looking for. Goes for, the draw here. So he can finish it off with this hero power.
It would be slightly unfortunate. If all his face. Purple still has the clear. You can see the agony still on Purple's face. We only saw a smile once, which was in the first game, I think.
I've been paying attention. I've been paying attention to a smile, unfortunately.
Taka Wonder, on the other hand, he has a very stone cold face.
Concentrated.
Yeah. That's good, right? As a Hearthstone player, you want to show no emotions.
There's Innovate from the Raven Idol, maybe. You could go Innovate, and then you could play the Mirekeeper for the ramp, and then just Innovate Onyxia next turn. I think it's going to do it. I love it.
Yeah. And if Onyxia sticks with her babies, he can, like, Power of the Wild. And, yeah, it's pretty good.
Exactly. I mean,
also known as Wonder is going to probably trade this. And, Ghost face? I don't know. I don't like this. Mm. Like, you have no reason to freeze the druid. It doesn't matter. Like, the druid is not going to like hit you for one and like ruin your dreams. On the other hand, if he trades the free frame to one of your minions, he can like manage to get more value. I would like to see the trade here from also known as Wander.
I mean, if you go face, I guess you're expecting the 3-3 to just trade into one of the cool sorcerers, right?
But do you want that?
Not really.
Yeah. I'd rather just like give away free damage
to the face
and free HP from the water elemental to help my boy survive.
Oh, goes for the face.
Also known as Wander chooses to go for face here. I don't know if that was like the best, but he already went for it, so.
Innovate Onyxia.
He can follow up with Swipe, Power of the Wild. That's a pretty good situation.
How much of the board can Wonder clear here?
Can he? He didn't clear last turn, and he's going to go for face again. Just hope he top decks a second file, but even that wouldn't be enough. I don't know, it's like pretty...
Yeah, he's one mana off being able to fireball ping off the Onyxia.
Pretty rough shape for Taka Wonder here. I'd rather be in purple shoes. In this current game, not in the series, because in the series, Taka Wonder still has like a mirror match in the country deck, so...
I mean, would you go Mana Worm, Fireball, trade in the Cult Sorcerer, and just ping off a 1-1 with your Water Lily? Your opponent's left with 5 1-1s. You have a Mana Worm and a...
That seems terrible, but it's probably the best play.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I mean. Like, it's kind of really awkward for AK Wonder here.
This is, like, what differentiates...
Like, a Zodrake feels even worse.
Yeah, this is what differentiates like the good players from the great players. Like, the great players know how to play really well the shittiest turn possible and like maximize the percentages.
Yeah.
Akawander opts to go for face, which I'm not sure if gives him any percentage of winning.
Yeah.
But would other play give him anything? Probably not either. I think Purple already calculated this in advance. He's like, yeah, I got it. I got this. Pretty good.
Seems good.
Onyxia and the Wisps. Strong. Pretty good, solid. Being Akawander, just like mentality-wise, do you queue the Zoo, which is like the best matchup, or do you queue the Mirror match?
I think, would you queue the Mirror match first? Because if you lost the favorable matchup, then suddenly you're in a really bad frame of mind. Or would you want to just get out of the way and not take an risk taking another loss?
Okay. This being the first game of the group and being very late, I would just go with the favorite matchup to first of all conceal information, yeah, and second of all not get myself tired.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Which is what he does. Yeah. He goes for the Zoo. Really good queuing by Akawander. Let's see if Purple can innervate his way out of this situation.
Yeah, no innervate so far.
Wait, what?
I Sea Giant?
I see Giant.
I see Giant too. I love it. I love it. But then it's kind of weird because it doesn't really interact with like... I mean, it's great with Valor Teacher, but...
Purple is crazy.
He's just grinning right now, like...
Yeah.
I love it.
I want to see Akawander's face. This will be priceless.
Thing
we,
is, though, the
we need the production guys to zoom in on Akawander's face when Purple Sea Giants.
Druid usually is unfavored against Zoo, but the Sea Giant could have a massive impact this game.
Seriously, what the fuck is Sea Giant doing there? Purple is nuts.
I mean, it works great with all the tokens. If you're expecting a lot of aggressive decks as well, it kind of... I don't want to say it makes sense, but...
So, ladies and gentlemen, Jackie Chan says a card doesn't make sense. You have to like imagine how bad that card is.
No, I don't think it's bad because I mean you have lots of ways of flooding the board, and yeah, but he's got Nyxia, he's got Violet Teachers, he's got Living Roots.
Yeah, I don't know. It's weird.
It's weird. It's weird, but it's also wonderful.
I would be like less surprised if he had like Draconid Crusher in that slot. I don't think you rough that. It's not like...
Yeah, I mean, there's lots of better Wrath targets in Zoo.
Yeah, Void Docker is...
Not really very threatening at all. Okay, just choose to Wrath it.
It fits the curve. We can give him that.
I mean, maybe with the Sea Giant in hand, you don't want to touch your opponent's board at all. You just let them build a board up and then just play the Sea Giant.
Sea Giant swipe. Turn the tides. Get
okay.
Wrecked.
Okay, so we have the Raven Idol.
Okay, what can he get?
Astral, Naturalize, or Feral Rage. Would you give Naturalize? Over the Feral Rage?
Hmm. Okay. The way we have to look at it is like, if you take Naturalize, your Emperor is likely to be really strong, but you give your opponent cards. If you take Feral Rage, you leave the Consummate to go for two turns, and he's probably going to...
He goes with the Naturalize. Yeah, I mean, it does kind of...
Makes sense.
Yeah.
You give him a lot of cards, but then... If the cards are bad, they're going to help you because he's going to play them, throw the board, and then you go like
play
Emperor.
The Sea Giant.
Yeah. This is fucking crazy.
Yeah, it makes sense. I love it. Love it. Okay.
Second Consummate is pretty good here for Akawander. And Innervate Emperor Duration is also like
good.
Pretty massive. Akawander needs to like make some efforts to be able to collect this board now. You have to play Abusive if you want to play the Juggler. That's like the unfortunate situation. So you'd probably keep the square for the square Argus next turn. So you go like Juggler, Abusive, Voidwalker, or Possessed. Mm. Doesn't seem that great, but you have to deal with the Emperor.
What do you think about... I was going to say something. I thought he had coin in his hand. I was going to say, what do you think about Abusive Argus? But there's no coin. So never mind.
Lul.
Lul. Okay.
I don't like Squire. I think you want
to
keep
Squire.
I mean,
do you have to deal with the Emperor? Like, Purple's only got three cards in hand. Like, he's not getting a massive reduction.
Yeah, you have to deal with the Emperor. Because you just lose to swipe if you don't kill the Emperor, right?
Yeah, yeah. The light protects.
Maybe he will not kill it. What do you think? Is he gonna kill it? He's gonna kill it.
Maybe
for sure.
Faces the place.
What?
Faces the place.
This is crazy.
Yeah. I mean,
is he gonna play the Sea Giant?
Yeah, would you give Sea Giant hero power?
Yeah, the Sea Giant is really good.
Yeah.
Sea Giant. Aqua Wonder. No facial expression.
Yeah. Just waiting for the reaction.
Is he human? Has science gone too far? Is Aqua Wonder a human, or is he a robot playing Hearthstone?
Okay. The Azure Drake swipe is now 5 mana as well. That's huge.
Maybe he didn't realize what he's playing against yet.
Maybe he's teched his deck to beat Zoo. He's teched his Druid deck to beat Zoo with the Sea Giant. I love it.
Maybe he plays like one Sea Giant for the purpose of like after you get the win with Druid, you know that they will kill Zoo, and after they kill Zoo, you have to see Giant to like fuck them up. It's just genius from Purple.
Well, maybe there's two Sea Giants.
Yeah, Purple is just a genius of Hearthstone.
Okay, ooh, he's gonna get really punished by the Azure Drake swipe here.
Purple is in heaven right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even has the big taunt follow-up for next turn.
Aqua Wonder needs to win now. Next turn,
yeah,
it's the 4
now
hits.
Or never.
And then it's GG. It's a good game, well played. He probably has to peddler into PO. Power overwhelming. Is the power going to be overwhelming enough to win Aqua Wonder the game?
Unfortunately, I don't think so.
So this is going to go to like a Druid Mirror.
Soulfire or Corruption?
He has Soulfire, Corruption, and Light Warden.
Yeah, I mean, Soulfire instantly deals with the... Yeah, okay. Makes sense.
Imgarmos is pretty shitty when your opponent has an Azure Drake. Imgarmos is only good against Druid in the early game. Later on, he's, like, worthless.
Would you consider Soulfiring the Azure Drake instead of the Sea Giant? Get rid of the spell damage.
I don't know. I don't know. Sea Giant is pretty big.
Yeah. The Sea Giant for Purple has come through strong. We were doubting it at the start of the game, but he's proving us wrong right now.
I mean, only because Aqua Wonder just went for a face and ignored the board.
Yeah, I mean, ignoring the Emperor did really cost him.
Yeah.
Like, if he hadn't ignored it, the Emperor, the Azure Drake swipe combo... Oh, another swipe. The Azure Drake swipe combo would have been 7 mana, so he wouldn't have been able to play it until now.
Yeah. Uprooter, no balls.
No balls.
No balls.
8 to the face.
That is the place. If Aqua Wonder tops, I think he's dead.
You have to top though, right? It's just another Sea Giant.
Sea Giant party everywhere. Yeah,
Sea
Purple won this.
Fiesta.
Game goes to 2-2. Purple just making a comeback with his Sea Giant Druid.
Love it. Love it.
He's also good in the mirror match. Insane!
Yeah, well, if it's token Druid, we don't know if it's token or C'Thun yet, right?
Oh yeah, if it's C'Thun...
It's not so good.
Who is favorite between Yogg Druid and C'Thun Druid?
I think Yogg.
Yeah, I was inclining to Yogg too, because I don't think C'Thun has that much power.
Yes, it's kind of slow and you have time to build up your board and have big swingy turns.
But also known as Wonder is the pioneer of C'Thun Druid. He was playing it when nobody else was playing it.
Yeah, that's
the same way that you were playing the Yogg Druid when nobody was playing the Yogg Druid.
Yeah, and we go to 2-2. Very close series after AK Wonder's mage start. Now the Sea Giant Druid.
Yeah, we just saw a giant. It's pretty good.
We saw Giant, and I want to see more. I want to see if there's two. I really want to know if there's two.
You
want to
see Giants?
After this, I'm definitely going to be asking Purple for the deck list after this. Like,
yeah.
Oh, so
I still cannot believe my eyes that I saw Sea Giant in Druid.
I mean, you would expect AK Wonder to bring C'Thun Druid, right?
Yeah, of course. He has to keep his brand.
Keep his brand.
Like, even if you lose in the tournament because you play the suboptimal Druid deck, you still have to keep your brand.
Exactly.
It's like, why bringing Reno Log? Like,
I see Sogoth!
You see Sogoth?
I do indeed.
I don't know, like, people really, like, want to be special.
Yeah.
I don't see Sogoth anymore. He threw away Sogoth starting first.
Rip Sogoth.
Why wouldn't he keep it? Such a good keep. Powerful card.
Oh, we see Wild Skill in Wonder Sand. Seems good.
Okay.
Goes for Reignado.
If Purple hasn't managed to hit something good, then he's
Innovate
in trouble.
Insta
peek.
Exactly what
that was a misplay. It's a misplay. Purple misplay for sure.
Should have hung around a bit.
Yeah, yeah. Because this tells Sakawada that Purple has a top tier card. Like, what other card would you instantly pick?
Wild Growth and Innovate would be the two that you instantly
pick.
Yeah.
Misplay.
Anyway, it's still great. And he has the Mykeeper into Mykeeper. Purple does.
There's no punish, though, because he played this turn, so it's irrelevant. Yeah.
They're both ramping really nicely. Wonder had the Wild Growth into the Mykeeper. Purple had the Innovate into
Purple
the
has the better hand, though. Purple just ramps again, and then he goes like Teacher, Coin,
really
Ball of the Wild.
Too. Wonder has the Teacher, too.
Wait a second.
Some.
Was that a misplay? What about just like creating a 2-2 token, trading the 3-3 into the 3-3, and then next time you go Teacher, Coin, Power of the Wild? You have a 3-3, you have a 2-2. If any of those survive, you completely obliterate your opponent. You smash him.
Smash him? I mean, maybe, but then you want to use it. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I like just doing that.
The 2-2 in the Power of the Wild.
I know. Purple should have like taken more time. He's playing way too fast. He wants to like preserve his energies. He feels the victory. He feels the blood.
Feral Rage, Munch, or Moonfire? I mean, the Sogoth can't be targeted by Munch.
Taking a sip of that energy drink. Purple is on fire.
I mean, this is a tough one. The Feral Rage is going to deal with stuff like Violet Teacher, Emperor, stuff like that. But... like at this stage, Purple still doesn't really know the extent of what AK Under's playing. Swipe.
I think you'd rather Feral Rage over swiping.
Yeah, I agree. Purple really wants to draw another cheap spell, so he can really go off with this Teacher and flood the board. Ancient of War is a huge draw, though.
How huge?
Humongous! And that is also a good draw. Wow, I mean, Purple could just go crazy with a Violet Teacher here.
You can go like Violet Teacher, Coin, Innervate, Swipe, Power of the Wild. That's pretty good.
I like it.
I like it, too. Just dome him. And if this fails, he has the safety net of Yuxaron later on. Just start
but
do
I mean,
it.
Your hand just says all or nothing right now. You just gotta do it, I think.
Yeah, just start do it. Trademark. I'm ready to learn. They are ready to learn.
Okay, and AK Wonder really has no way of dealing with this right now.
Yep.
But that is a huge tempo swing for Purple, isn't it?
Indeed. He wants to like Teacher Mulch Living
Roots. Yeah, he has the Teacher Mulch Living Roots. Would you trade the Ancient of War in a 2-2? There's no way.
No way. You go for Phase because he's going to trade for you. There's no incentive to that. Purple needs a good draw. The thing is that next turn...
That's a Reno Jackson.
Is it good? Is it playable? It's not playable.
I mean, you just play it as a minion, right? You just play it now because it's never going to get there.
Yeah.
You're never going
to... Just like play Reno Jackson and Living Grooves the 5-2. Double trade.
I mean, how desperate are you to kill the Violet Teacher?
You aren't. Do you want to kill the Violet Teacher?
Yeah, I mean, what if he draws, like, Nourish, a couple of spells? Like, you don't... Like, Violet Teacher is such a threat. The 1-1s aren't really a threat at all. Like,
I need to read this card.
I mean, you can...
the Slitherer stunt can be targeted by spells or hero powers.
Have you never played it?
I don't even have it in my collection.
What?
Like, who the heck plays this card? Come on. I'm trying to play, like, top-tier decks. This card ain't top-tier.
Okay. Is he going for the Reno? Yeah, seems sensible. Removing the Violet Teacher, I like it. And the socket's gonna come down.
Ah, no effect. The Reno Druid.
Sogoth.
Sogoth the Sleeterer. Sleeterer.
And Yogg's. One big thing here is Yogg's spells can't target Sogoth.
He can have random spells still.
Yeah, he can have Deadly Shot, etc. But.
How many spells did Purple play this game? So he went.
He's played a few. He's played a couple of Innervates.
Coin? No. He went Innervate.
He went Ravenado, Innervate.
Okay, Ravenado, he took the Innervate. And then turn two, like, he went Innervate, Mire Keeper. Yeah. And then he played Mire Keeper again. He went for Face. And then, like.
There was a Feral Rage in there somewhere. A swipe.
There was a Feral Rage, there was Swipe, there was, like, the Coin, there was, like, the Power of the Wilds.
Yeah.
Not that many spells.
Six or seven.
Six or seven. Very little. I'm not sure if Yogg is powerful enough yet. He might have to do it. He might have to, like, YOLOLO. The Yogg Saron.
I mean, would you have ever considered trading the Reno into the Sogoth there to get its health a bit lower?
He's gonna do the trade for you, mostly. Mm,
true.
Now you can get your Reno jacked and just kill the Sogoth somehow.
Yeah. Oh, that's another option, but
yeah,
I like the Yogg here, right?
Okay, yo, GG. Reno can attack.
Praise
Let's see.
Yogg.
One.
Avenging Wrath is great.
Insane.
If you can do some work to the Fandral.
Two spells. Free.
Anything. Zero Murlocs. Two anything. Lay on Hands. What's he going to heal, though?
Face.
He wants his own face. That is a huge Yogg. That Lay on Hands. Oh, my. And he can now
Fireball.
Even...
Fireball.
That is the best possible target. And now he can easily trade the Reno into the Sogoth.
And the Reno gets jacked. Wow, this is insane.
That is one of the best Yoggs I've ever seen in the tournament, man. That was ridiculous.
Purple just... esports this situation and you see him laughing. He's like so happy.
Purple was clearly praising Yogg this morning and he has been heavily rewarded.
Yeah. Purple just feels the victory. Feels the blood.
Wow.
Also known as Wonder cannot do anything. He needs like Wonder to get himself out of the situation. He really does. The free cards are Innervate, Bite, Mark of the Nature. Mark of Nature. I think the plan of Fakie Wonder is
to also Saron. Praise Yogg.
Yeah.
I would love to see a Yogg top deck.
Competitive Hearthstone, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, what can you say?
The card is just too good not to play if you play out the spells in your deck.
Exactly, yeah. You just win games on it soon.
What does this card in purple sand do? Cultist. Scrum it's for Cthune, right?
Yeah, it's Cthune. It's usually a 7-6. For but six mana.
Yeah, it's buff because of the Paladin card, the Discover Paladin card.
Yeah.
Holy shit, this game, this series.
So
this clear Druid
the
deck.
Board, but the Onyxia is just gonna come down.
Yeah, he had a Leon Hands, he had everything he wanted.
Mulch into Novice Engineer.
Doesn't need anything right now. Purple just wins if he plays Onyxia. He has Power of the Wild next turn.
AK Wonder needs a huge draw here.
He needs Yogg.
Living Roots is not what he's looking for.
He needs to survive. Just Living Roots, Dude of the Claw Town, just try to survive.
Would you Living Roots for damage or just as the two saplings?
Two saplings. Yeah. You can just deal two damage to 1/1. Yeah, probably dealing two damage to 1/1 is the best.
Yeah, I think I prefer that as well.
Because, like, you just want to survive one more turn.
It takes you one less damage, and plus if he has things like Power of the Wild. He goes for the... Okay, he goes for the saplings.
I don't mind this. Small difference.
9 to 11. So Purple is currently counting, working out how much damage we can get through here.
It's 15.
I mean, the power of the 18. Wild. Is, the power of the wild is 19 damage.
That's not really how you count it.
But
now even a draft is a bit off.
4, 6, 8, 10. Out loud. I think he's one off right now. He's actually one off.
He's counting out loud.
And that should be it. That's the game.
Yeah.
Wow, what a comeback by Purple.
Holy shit.
Like he was 2-0 down to the mage.
This thing was insane.
The sea giant druid came through strong.
This was weird.
Wow, I mean, what a comeback by Purple. That was really...
He just
really
stole
something.
The series with the Yogg-Saron and with the Sea Giant. Yeah, that I mean, was, like, weird.
The Yogg-Saron was just so crazy. Like, just won the game on its own, really.
He only had, like, 6 or 7 spells. Like, he had, like, completely...
But then also the Sea Giant and the Druid was actually huge. Because, like, the Zoo matchup would have been a lot harder to win without the Sea Giant.
We just saw Druid in its complete form.
Druid doing what Druid does best.
Okay, so that was the first game. We're going to continue in the second game. I don't think we are going to cast anymore, but you're going to have some better casters than us.
Yeah. See you later, guys.